Today I'm sitting in Diamond Park. I'm on the island of Koh Pich. Merity is off on a trip to Battambang to sort out some paperwork for us. So I'm bachelor filming today. This park wouldn't look out of place in parts of Europe, and that is, as I would say to my English students, an example of foreshadowing. We've actually been here before, visiting Trialium Park. A link to that video should be up above you now. The garden could almost be a town square, as it even comes with its own town hall building. Koh Pich is the newest district of Phnom Penh on the Mekong and Bassac rivers. In fact, if you went back to the year 2000, this would all be basically swampland. 50 years ago, Koh Pich didn't even exist. Even today, some maps of Phnom Penh don't show the 68-hectare island located in front of the Naga Casino complex, where the Tonle Bassac meets the Mekong River. Legend has it that a ship sank on the river mouth, and the island grew from the subsequent sediment buildup.
The Koh Pich City Hall and surrounding gardens have a Roman theme. This seems slightly out of place in the capital of Cambodia, but the adjoining developments has a European, or more specifically a Parisian, theme going on. It has three fountains, all of which were not in operation today. There are also very well manicured hedges that complement the Roman statues dotted around the garden. There are also four gazebos that are at each corner of the garden that can be used for a picnic. In the morning, you'll usually find joggers out or people cycling around the park. The City Hall building can be used for wedding functions and has been used for an official ASEAN dinner reception. Opened in 2010, the building and Roman gardens can seat around 4,000 guests, with a price of a table starting at the high point of its popularity of $500.
A neighbourhood named Elise has a style inspired by Paris. In other areas, high towers are under construction. The Elise project includes unique French-style commercial buildings in Phnom Penh. It is a luxurious French-style development inspired by the Champs-Élysées in Paris, with cafes, luxury specialty shops and hotels. Apparently all for that perfect Parisian lifestyle. But you know, in the heart of Phnom Penh, Cambodia. Walking around the streets of this development, you can see many empty shops. This development started in 2014, but I feel it was mostly aimed towards Chinese coming in to live and invest in Cambodia. It has been hit badly by COVID, and with the zero tolerance program in China, it may not recover in the short term. I hope it does though, as this will provide an unusual contrast in Phnom Penh, essentially creating a Chinatown here, as is the case with many cities in the region and of course around the world. A much better version than the area say near Hualapong in Bangkok and neighbouring Thailand.
The streets here are quite quiet, with only a small amount of activity. It is quiet and relaxed, not like the hustle and bustle only a kilometre away in the centre of Phnom Penh. There have been numerous new condo developments here, where the developers have promised amenities such as swimming pools, tennis courts and gyms to give owners a five-star luxury living experience, along with panoramic views of the river. Prices have ranged from $100,000 to over $1 million, with foreign investors being targeted as potential buyers, helped by changes made to old property laws, which now allow condos and apartments to be 100% owned by non-citizens. You are heavily fined if you pick mangoes here, or even pick them up off the ground. They will cost you $5 per mango. Hopes for a new diplomatic quarter based on the island have been raised after the Embassy of South Korea opened its doors on Elite Road. With so much achieved in a relatively short time, the rise of Koh Pich from marshy farmland to high-end luxury has not always been easy. As Phnom Penh expands at an astonishing rate each year, all eyes will be on the ambitious diamond trapped between three rivers and wondering how bright it will shine in an ever-changing city.
That's all for today, guys. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe, like, and share, and join us next time.